The Naggaroth Nightmares, though a relatively new team, have had an influx of incredible talent and are already carving themselves a reputation as nightmares for their opponents. Now, in this video, we're going to be painting a lineman, but the methods and techniques used can be applied to any model in the team. So when you're ready, let's get started. So before we begin painting, we'll need to undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've used Mechanica Standard Grey. Now this is a great mid-tone colour for applying all those colours later on. So the first colour we'll be using, we'll be painting the sleeves and the trousers using Skaven Blight Dinge. So I'm just going to get my medium layer brush, just going to apply a little bit to my palette like so, and a little touch of water as well, just so it runs a bit better. And then we'll start picking out those trousers and those sleeves. Now you will notice, obviously, it's a grey on top of grey. You may not initially notice that much of a difference, but once you get that shade on later on and highlight it, it will give it a really nice purpley grey tone to it. With the trousers and sleeves now layered, we're going to move on to the next step, which is to start base coating the boots and the gloves. And for this, we'll be using Staggered On Scale Green. Now, keeping my medium layer brush, I'm just going to apply a little bit more to the palette like so. And again, a little touch of water as well, just so it flows into those cracks a lot easier. And then we'll just start applying it. Now you want to spend a little bit of attention just around where the boots meet the trousers, just so you don't end up getting it onto the grey. And if you do, just touch that up later. And there we are with the boots and the gloves now base coated. We're going to move on to painting the armour. And for this, we'll be using Xeris Purple. Again, I'm going to keep the same brush, so the medium layer brush. Just apply a little bit to my palette like before. And again, a touch of water, like so. And then we're just going to start layering it onto the armour, which will be the chest plate. There's the helmet, and there's also gauntlets and the shin guards. Now here, I'm actually painting over some of the metal banding because I can touch that up later, and also some straps on the shoulder pads. Again, you can paint those over later, so don't worry about splodging on those. And there we are with the armor now layered up. We're gonna move on to blocking in some other areas on the figure. To start with, we'll start painting the straps using Zandri Dust. We'll paint all the metal areas using Lead Belcher. We'll pick out any gold details using Retributor Armor. Then we'll block in the skin using Rakar Flesh. And finally, we'll paint the hair using Celestra Grey. So starting with that Zandri Dust, I'm just going to apply a little bit to my palette like so, and again I'll thin this down, and this is all the straps you'll see across the model, so whether that's on the back of his gauntlets, or his armour bits on his legs, and also on the shoulder pad here. So we'll do the shoulder pad bit first, so it's just on the top there. And you could always do a couple of coats if some of that purple's shown through. You've got a belt as well, so we'll do his belt. And there's straps at the back of the legs as well. With the straps and loincloth now base coated, we're going to move on to painting the metal areas. And for this, we'll be using Lead Belcher. I'm using a medium layer brush. Now, around some of the areas, like the banding here, that's quite easy to get to. But around some of the areas, like the buckles, just be really careful. And if you do splodge, again, just use the other colour to tidy up. With the Lead Belcher base coated, we're now going to use Retributor Armour on the little motif on the crest of the helmet. We're now going to move on to painting the face, and for this we'll be using Rakar Flesh. I have thinned this down quite a bit. I'll do a couple of layers of this, just give it a nice smooth complexion. With the skin done, we're now going to start painting the hair using Celestra Grey. And again, just thin this down a bit, do a couple of coats. And there we are, with the hair now done, we're going to move on to applying a bunch of shades onto the model. To start with, we'll use Drutchy Violet and we'll apply it on the armour, the sleeves and the trousers. Then we'll pick out the skin and the gold using Rykan Flesh Shade, and then everything else we'll shade with Norn Oil. So starting with the Drutchy Violet, I'm just going to apply a little bit to my brush. I'm using a medium layer brush again, just because it's got a nice point to it and a bit of control as well. And what I'll do is then start applying it to the actual armour. Now I want to be careful here and try not to get on the metallic areas and the straps, so just be neat. But if you do, you might splodge on by accident, just tidy back up after. And don't forget, we're going to be doing the trousers and the sleeves as well. Once the Drutchy Violet's dry, we're just going to shade the gold details and the skin with Rykan Flesh Shade. And just take your time and try and avoid the other areas if you can. Now we're going to move on to our final shade, which is Norn Oil. And what we're going to do here is just apply the shade to all those areas that have not yet been touched. So that's metallics, black leather, so the Stegodon scale, and also the Zandri Dust. With all those shades now applied and dry, we're now going to move on to applying some highlights and layers to the model. Now to start with, I'll be using Dawnstone to highlight the trousers and the sleeves. I'll be using a small layer brush this time, Just going to apply a little bit of water to the Dawnstone. Get a nice point to it as well. Give it a little bit of a spin, like so. And then I'll just turn the model around so you can see the sleeves better. And all I'm going to do is just do some edge highlights around the folds of the cloth. Just take your time when doing this. And there we are, with the sleeves and trousers now highlighted. We're going to move on to highlighting the gloves and boots. And for this, I'll be using Fenris in grey. Now I'll continue using my small layer brush. Just apply a little bit to the palette. Again, a touch of water. Twist it to a nice point. And this is probably key at this point as well, because you want to get a nice point to this part. And there we are. So what we want to do here is just be really careful when painting around those highlighted areas, especially around these edges of the boots. Just get a nice point to your brush. If you do make any mistakes, just go back over those colours you painted previously. There we are, with the boots and gloves now done. We're going to move on to highlighting the armour. And for this, we'll be using Jean Stealer Purple. Again, I'm going to continue using my small layer brush. Let's get a little bit of purple on my brush like so. Again, touch more water, and then we'll start highlighting. There's some cool areas here where you can just use the edge of the brush, like the shoulder pad here. I can just run the edge of my brush, so I get a nice, consistent line. Some of the other areas you might have to just be a little bit more finicky about and actually start picking out using the tip of your brush, like on the breastplate just here. And there we are, with the armour now highlighted, we're going to move on to picking out a load more highlights on the model. To start with, we'll pick out the straps using Screaming Skull. We'll then tidy up the face using a little bit of Rakar Flesh. We'll then highlight it straight after using Pallid Witch Flesh. Then we'll pick out the hair using Ulthran Grey. And finally, we'll start highlighting all the metallics using Stormhost Silver. But to start with, we'll use the Screaming Skull on the straps. I'll just apply a little bit to my palette like so. Again, get a nice point to that small layer brush. Just give it a bit of a twist if it's playing up. There we are. And then we'll start highlighting. So what I'm going to do here is just either side of each of the straps is just do a little bit of a highlight like so. Don't have to do it all the way around, just in some key areas. With the straps now painted, we're going to move on to tidying up the skin. And for this, we'll be using Rakar Flesh. Now, the main reason for this is just to pick out some of those raised areas like the cheeks, the nose, and the jaw. You can also pick out the lips as well. This will just give it a bit more definition when we start highlighting. With the skin now tidied, we're going to start highlighting with Pallid Witch Flesh. I'm just going to concentrate this on the tips of the nose. Quite neatly drawn around there. On the lips. Also around the eyes as well. And the cheeks. If you do make any mistakes, just tidy back up again with Rakar Flesh. With the skin done, we're now going to move on to highlighting the hair. And for this, we're using Ulthran Grey. Again, just keep it to the raised areas. With the hair now done, using Stormhost Silver, we're going to start highlighting all the gold and silver areas. And where possible, just use your edge of your brush, just for a nice thin line. And there we are, with the metals now highlighted, we're going to move on to painting the scales on the loincloth. Now, to start with, we'll use Warboss Green, we'll then shade it with Beeltan Green, and then we'll finish off with a highlight of Skarsnik Green. So starting off with the Warboss Green, I'm just going to get my medium artificer brush, because it gives me a bit more of a point. For more control as well. We'll just get a nice point to our brush, like so, and then we'll start layering it on. All you need to do really is find where the scales are. I mean, you've got a wash in the recesses, so you can actually use that as a guide as well. And just start layering over the actual scales themselves, just to pick them out. And actually, when you get up to the top here, I'll probably just layer that entirely. With that layer dry, we're now going to apply Beeltan Green to the scales. Now, to start off with, at the very top here, just apply it on liberally. As you get to the bottom, just be careful not to get on the Xandri dust. And when it's dry, I'd recommend doing a second coat just around the top here, just to add a bit of depth. Once the shade's dry, we're now going to start highlighting. On most of the scales, you just want to draw a nice little thin line around the actual scales themselves, like so. Actually, at the top here, where the folds of the cloths are, normally when we do a highlight on cloth, we just do a nice straight line. What I'd do here instead is more of a staggered line that gives it more of a rough kind of feel to it. That really adds that scaly kind of look. Just stab it, or stipple it if you like. And there we are, with the loincloth now done, we're going to move on to the final details, which is to paint the eyes, the eyebrows, and the lips. Now, for the eyes and the eyebrows, I'll be using a Bad and Black, and for the lips, I'll be using Bloodletter. So starting with the eyes and the eyebrows, I'm just going to get a little bit of Bad and Black on my palette, and I'm going to thin this down a lot more than I normally would, so probably a whole paintbrush of water, as opposed to just a little touch. I can get my brush to a nice point, and because it's really watery, it will flow into those eyes a lot better. You can get a nice thin line for the eyebrows as well. So what I'm going to do really here is just, the detail's there already for you, but because it's a bit thinned down, it'll just run in nicely. So just neatly just get the oval of the eye, and then just above it, just draw a nice little line, like so. And the actual detail is there for you, again, to assist that. And there we are, the eye's done. We're now just going to move on to painting the lips, and we'll be using blood letter for this. Now you can do a couple of coats, depending on the vibrancy, but one should be enough. When that's dry, we recommend basing this model in the same way as the rest of the team. With the model now based, she's ready to join the rest of her teammates and cause havoc on the pitch. Now there are a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when applying those base coats, just take your time, and if you do make any mistakes, you can always neaten up at a later stage. And secondly, when applying those shades, again, because you'll be doing multiple shades at the same time, just take your time and just be neat about it. We hope you've enjoyed this video. We hope you enjoy painting your own Naggaroth Nightmares, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.